Hi everyone, and welcome. We made a three-part tutorial video on connecting Postman to Xero with OS2. However, we thought we'd add an extra fourth video, just a quick little one, just on debugging errors you just get inside of Postman. Now, there are a couple things you can do wrong or muck up that can lead to an error 500 or not being able to make successful calls. And I'm just going to show you some of the most common errors that you can run into. Now, typically, the most common error that people have been running into is hitting an error 500 immediately after requesting the token. Now, if I request the token at the moment, oh no, sorry, something went wrong. Now, typically, that could be due to a couple of reasons. It could be either my client ID or secret are incorrect. So maybe I have an extra character on the end of there. Maybe when I've gone Control-V, I've accidentally left a V on, something like that. The 010 ID, that could also be incorrect, although you won't hit an error 500 if that is incorrect in the first place. The redirect URI, that could be different to what we actually have for you on the My Apps page of the Developer Center. So, for example, if your redirect URI inside of Postman has a forward slash on the end, while the redirect URI inside of here does not, that won't be allowed through. You need to have these match exactly what they are over here. Other errors can be that the scopes are either misspelled, invalid, or you don't have access to that required scope. There are some restricted scopes that we do not allow access to, and you have to talk to us to get access to them. Those are listed down the bottom here. So if I, for example, try to add bank feeds to my scopes, of course, I wouldn't be allowed through. Now, I know exactly what the error is because I added it in myself. I added an extra S on the end of accounting.transactions. So if I take all of those off and update that and get a new access token, fantastic, I'm allowed through. Now, because I logged in earlier, it's just taken me straight to the user account information access screen, but usually you'd be hit with a user login page first. Other little things that can go wrong. If you get a invalid grant error when refreshing your token, it may be that the refresh token you're using is old, expired, or invalid. So as an example, as mentioned before, and I believe it was part two of the tutorial, refresh tokens last for 60 days at a time or once they're used. If after they're used for the first time, they'll give you 30 minutes of access to allow to use that token continuously, basically. We thought, just in case anything happens and you do not get the response back, so for your next refresh or access token, so say I make the refresh call and I don't get both of those two back, of course I'll have to use the next refresh token to then get my next access token, but I don't have either of those, so what am I meant to do? Well, usually you would have to have your user go through and get your and manually refresh the connection. However, we decided with this 30 minutes of access that we allow you to have after the refresh token is first being used, that allows you to make the same call over and over again until you do get the access token and the refresh token, and then from there you can use those new refresh tokens and access tokens. Now, you'll get an invalid grant error when the refresh token is basically past that first half hour of it being used. So, as an example, it won't work for me right now because, of course, the CA8 token at the moment has only just been refreshed. But if I copy that out, let's just open up a new notepad like that. I'm just going to chuck that in there. And then let's refresh this twice. CE6E1 and now 4C1. Fantastic. That's two definitely different refresh tokens. I could now actually come up and chuck that as my refresh token and still be able to update my calls. Now, it's currently just before 4:30 in the afternoon. If after 5 o'clock I want to still use this access token, I won't be able to use that. I'll now get an invalid grant error. I'll have to now use, well, maybe one of those two other refresh tokens I've already refreshed, if it was within the half hour of their extended limit, However, I'll have to use the most recently generated refresh token. So as an example, this one right here, this 1AC, however, that is also added right up into your refresh token every time you make a refresh call as well. Other things just to be aware of, inside of the test script for refresh token, and then the same for the connections endpoint, we have these handy little scripts which will automatically shove for the refresh token call, the access and refresh token up into here for you, into the environment. And then for the connections endpoint, it should do the same with the tenant ID. However, there's an issue with this one at the moment, so it may not do it. And if you do make the call with the tenant ID, it may actually strip out your Xero tenant ID. So if I get connections endpoint at the moment, there we go, I've just gotten it again, 200, that's all good. There you go, unfortunately it stripped it out. So you may want to get rid of this one. On the invoices as well, we have a pre-request script, which will automatically update and refresh your tokens for you. So if you're wondering why you have infinite access after using invoices for 3 hours, maybe one afternoon, that will be the reason why this call is refreshing your tokens each time. So if you want to just basically hang out in Postman all day and without having to worry about refreshing your tokens, and you want to have multiple different calls being made, so maybe one to the organization endpoint, all I would do is come along, duplicate the invoices call to keep the pre-request script in there, and then change out whatever call you want here. So now maybe this one, I want to go to organization instead, get an organization, and go on that. Oh, I'm not going to be allowed to. Now, why am I not allowed to? That's because I do not have the scope required for organization. Now, I know what the scope is for organization off the top of my head, because I look at it all day, and that will be accounting.settings. So if I want to chuck accounting.transactions in there for a second time, take out that bit, copy that across, paste that in. Fantastic. I still won't be able to call the organization's endpoint. That's because I haven't reauthorized my app. Now, to add any extra scopes, you will have to reauthorize your app with a organization. So all I have to do there, again, is come back to getting started, authorization, get a new access token, request the token, there you go, allow the access, and then select any additional organizations or connect to that your organizations. Now, we are looking to make the screen maybe a bit more clear, but when you're already connected to an organization, it will display the number of organizations you are connected to right at the start. If you need to see what names they are connected on the screen, you can click on here, scroll right to the bottom, and see which organizations I'm connected to. So as an example, I'm just going to connect to demo company again here. But also, if you don't have enough permissions in a single organization, you also have these more permissions required header here with some grayed out organizations. You need to be a standard user or above to be able to connect a app to an organization. So just talk to whoever has managed user access within their organization and get your permission bumped up to a standard user or above. Or have a different user who does have standard user above log in for you on this and connect up all the organizations and everything. So I'm going to connect up demo company, and then yeah. Oh, and also we can see that now that I've added settings as well, while that was in step one of the video, we can now see set my organization settings are also being managed in this wee little blurb right here. Fantastic. Got myself a new access token. Let's set the new access token. Let's set the new refresh token. Fantastic. I'm just going to refresh my tokens just to be sure. Awesome. And now, can I make a call on the organization endpoint? No, I cannot. Why can I not? It's because I don't have my tenant ID. Now, let's just send another one for the get connections. There you go. We can see now that I have two organizations connected. I know that that one's a bit later than this one was. So let's just simply connect the tenant ID. Set tenant ID there. Fantastic. Oh, actually, hang on, I'm going to have to add that. Fantastic, there we go. Right, now instead of getting a 403, I'm going to get my organization details. Fantastic, there we go, all good to go. Righto, folks, as mentioned in part three, if you do have any questions or you're running into any errors yourself inside of Postman trying to connect to Xero, please get in touch with us at api@xero.com, or alternatively, raise a case with us on Xero Central. So go to the website, central.xero.com, and raise a case with us, and we'll be more than happy to help. Have a great rest of your day, folks, and happy APIing. Bye-bye.